Hello student, now today's session we learn about the NA stand or how we can insert the NA as a foreground or how we can insert the NA as a background. As a background you know very well we are using the body tag and in body tag we are using the attribute of background attribute of the body tag. So this also we have learned that if we want to insert the NA as a background then we are using the body attribute. Background. But if you want to insert the image at the foreground or the image you want to sit there on a particular line, then what we have to do, we can use the other one separate tag, image tag. Okay, so today we learn about the image tag, how we can use the image. First we can write that the image and then we can write SRC. SRC is mean the source. We can write the ing and then we can write SRC, it means the source of the image. Here we can start with inverted comma and then we can see the image which you want to insert there. So we can move there on the picture option and then I am selecting this desert image. So what we have to do, click on that particular image, move on that properties option and in this property you can copy the location of the image which you want to insert either in a foreground or as a background. So we can copy this location. Here I am copying this one, this copy the location, control C, and then you can paste or after this inverted comma. After this, we can use there the slash sign and write there the name of the image. The name of the image is there, Bezel. So this we can copy or you can write this name there also. So we can copy this Bezel and the location of the file or the extension of the file, it is .jpg. This is JPG image. First of all, copy the name of the file, control C. So here we can write the control paste, we can use the paste option and then dot. After the dot, we can write the extension of the file. So the file extension is the .jpg. So what we have to do, we can write the .jpg. Okay, and then close this angle also. Here we can close the next tab at body and then we can close the slash HTML. And then save. After saving the file, you can run this file. So this file name is the image1.html. I am using that image1.html file here. You can see this image as in a foreground. Okay, but if you want to change the height or width of that particular image because you're showing as a background, so you want to change the height and width. Then we can use here the height and width attribute of this image. So here we can write height equal, then we can write 300, okay, inverted, and then width equal, here I am writing 400, okay, and then see this file, but then run. You can see the changes, whatever height and width I have given there, you can see the changes. That particular image. Okay, so this is height and width attribute of the image tag. This height and width attribute only we are using for a foreground image only. Because if you want to insert the image as a background, that image showing whichever complete property. Whatever size and whatever height and width is there, it's showing default size, height and width in a background image. But as a foreground, if we want to insert the image, then we can change the height or the width also of that particular image. So this is ing tag, image source, src is the source. If you want to insert the image as a background, then what we have to do, we can write the background attribute of this body tag. Here only we can write body background. You can write here the body background, okay, then equal, and then in inverted comma, that complete location, which means you want to insert here as a background, the same location, or let's say if you want to change the location, then you want, if you want to change the picture, then you can copy the particular location of the picture, and then paste on that inverted, close this inverted, and then you run the file, so it's showing as in a background. But it is as a foreground, if you want to insert the image, then we can use the ing src tag and then we can. can copy the location of the file or the location of the image which you want to insert as a foreground image. And then you can take care of the height, and then you can take care of the width also of the image. So here I have pasted that all these things. This all you can learn today, and you can learn about the background also. You can run back all the tabs, whatever I am showing you, that all you can learn today regarding the IFGSRC tab, and the background also you can learn. If I want to insert the image at the background, then we can use the same location. Only attribute we can use in a body tab. Like this, here I am using body and then background and then image SRC. This is image SRC tag for inserting the image, or you want to change the height of it, then only that particular value only you can change. And showing you this one also. If I am changing the width of the image, here I am giving the width of the image 700, and then see. And then you can see the height of the image is showing. It's showing the image like this only. It is a 700 height, whatever I am giving. Refresh this image and you can see the width. Or you want to change the alignment, then what we have to do? We can change the alignment also. We can write the alignment back here, or we can start setting the center. If I want to change the image in a center position, so we can write as the center. Here I am changing the width 300 and this height also I am using there 200. Okay, save this and refresh this image, or you can see the changes, whatever you are doing there, you can see that the changes. The image is going in a center position because I am giving there the alignment center. The only center alignment you can use in a subframe, okay? But here I am using the subframe center tab, or you can close here the select center after completing the tabs. You can use here select center tab. But if you want to change the image alignment left and right, then what we have to do? No need to use here the subframe left or right. Here we can write align equal left or align equal right. Whatever alignment you require, you can write here. In that particular angle only you can write align equal left or align equal right, whatever alignment you require. Only the center alignment, this we can use here separately also, as well as we can use here in a particular text. We can give here in an angle also. We can use here align equal center also, then also it is running here. Okay? So the center only we can use separately, but that's right we can use in an angle only. Here only we can write align equal right, align equal left, or we can use align equal center also. So this is all for today. We learned that all how we can give here the alignment, how we can use here the height or width of the image. Okay, so this is all for today. Thank you.